So it looks like the streak of returns is not slowing down anytime soon, because we have had another two on last night's episode of Monday Night Raw. And oh my god, WWE is so good. Like, what's going on? So we've had Finn Balor, we've had John Cena all in the space of a couple days, by the way. And now we have not only Keith Lee, but also Goldberg coming back on Raw. What is happening? I don't really know, but they're making some mad moves and I'm loving it. Now, Goldberg's a pretty controversial one, because anytime he returns these days, it's kind of like, it's bad, because he really just ruined himself by winning against The Fiend. That's what really just made everyone turn on him. It's not like it was his choice to win the Universal Championship against The Fiend, but the fact that it did happen meant that the fans completely turned on him, because no one wanted to see that. You know, The Fiend was meant to be like unbeatable, and then Goldberg of all people come back and beat him. Like, nah, that just ruined things. So anytime he comes back nowadays, it's interesting. It's very, very interesting, you know. But we'll see how the public's opinion forms of him this time around. I'm not sure what exactly he's gonna... Oh, wait. This whole thing has Bobby Lashley involved. And Bobby Lashley is the WWE champion, so I guess we know what Goldberg's gonna be doing here. Okay. I mean, that's fine. You know, if he does step up to Bobby Lashley, Bobby Lashley will squash him like a bug. I'm sure of it. No, I am. I'm sure. Please, don't beat Bobby Lashley. You know what we need? We need Brock Lesnar to come back to take on Bobby Lashley. Not Goldberg. I'm sorry, Bill. Will Battleheim. But, nah. I mean, I like him, he's a legend, but just maybe not go after a championship every single time you come back, you know. So the match that we're going to be watching here is actually Bobby Lashley versus Keith Lee. So that's why Keith Lee returned, came back, challenged Bobby Lashley, and I'm sure this is for the championship as well. Haven't seen Raw, by the way. If you're new to my channel, I do these reactions like first time. I don't watch the shows live because, number one, it's way too late into the night, you know. I gotta get some sleep these days. Can't be having these late nights all the time, especially during the week. And yeah, I think it just, you know, having first time reactions makes things more interesting, you know, instead of me already seeing something and reacting to it and then being like, yeah, cool, man, whatever, I already saw this one. So without further ado, let's sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. I know some of you were telling me to hurry the flip up and start reacting in my last video, which is fine. Maybe I talk for too long, but when I talk for too long, I feel like I'm on a roll. And I'm always saying stuff that's informative. I'm not just waffling on, like the waffling podcast, you know what I mean? Anyways, let's go. Wait a minute, are we recording? We better be recording, because I need a bottle of water. Tres, dos, uno, let's go. Drills him into the corner with such speed, such height, such precision, such accuracy. Oh, he comes back with the elbow. I don't even know what I'm doing right now, but I am in the zone. I'm feeling like a bone. Oh, Keith Lee, follow up. No, underneath. Who's going to get the better of it? Oh, yeah, I was a bit... what's the word? Without swearing. That wasn't great, you know. I mean, that was a good sequence of moves back and forth, but the way it ended was, you know... I think Bobby was trying to get the offensive move, but then so was Keith, and then they kind of just clash in an awkward way. Yeah. Alright. MVP there, shouting at him, telling him to get his head back in the game. You're the almighty. You're the chosen one. Oh, that's Drew McIntyre, actually. Never mind. You're the almighty. You're the Kofi squasher. Eh? Is that a new nickname for him? It should be. Because he destroyed that man. Anyways, pop up. And... no. Lashley comes back. Hooks it. Drags him down. Not bad. Can you imagine Keith Lee won the flipping... I assume this is a championship match, right? Can you imagine he won the WWE Championship on his return? That would be insane. Remember, he was a double champion in NXT? I mean, he has got what it takes, you know? He's done some some craziness before, and he's such a talented wrestler, and it's insane. It still blows my mind how much of a high flyer he is. You know, it's just the good old saying, don't judge a book by its cover. You know, he may be a big guy, but he can still fly. Oh, but he's not doing too well here. Come on, Keith. You gotta get your head in the game. You gotta get... What's that from? Get your head in the game. I think it's some Disney movie from back in the day. Probably like flipping Lemonade Mouth or something. Oh, he gets taken out of the ring. He's a little bit stumbly. Come on, the crowd's like, get yourself back in there, Keith. If I was in the front row, I'd be telling him straight up, yo, you have what it takes. Don't be giving up now. You're not tired. Keep going. Keep fighting till the very end. How bad do you want it? Oh, can he get him here? Lashley is a pretty strong man, but I think he's struggling there, wasn't he? Gets him out into the post. Followed up with a close. Oh, just a little bit of a hug, you know, against the post. Nothing too serious. Into the ring he goes. Into the thick of it. Oh, into the thick of it. Right, come on, Keith. Pull yourself together, man. Oh no. MVP calls distractions. Classic move from the manager. Such a classic thing. Dirty, cheating antics. Terrible. Disgraceful. Oh, here he goes. Full speed ahead. Oh, and he hits him with a spear. God damn. At this stage, it's pretty much over, you know. I mean, how is Keith gonna bring himself back here? For the past like couple of minutes, he's just been an absolute, like, he's just pretty much out of it, you know. No offense whatsoever. He's just getting battered at this point. It's pretty much done. But this shows that Bobby Lashley is the one. He's the almighty, you know. They're still showing us that he is dominant. He's the champion. You know, he steps up to anyone. I mean, look at the size of the man, you know. He's not messing about. He really isn't. And I'm very glad he is a champion and he's getting like such a good run with this title, because it's very well deserved. But now he's looking to finish it here with his classic. Oh wait, can he lock it though? Can he lock it? Yeah, it's getting locked. And it is so close. Oh my. Oh, he breaks it! Bloody hell! Wait, nah! Oh. There was a little slight glimmer of hope, but he just gets shut down once again. And here comes the final spear to finish it off. Oh, God. Yeah. That's how it ends. Not a chance. He's kicking out of that. Yeah. Good effort from Keith Lee, you know. You know, he did pretty... Yeah, he didn't do great, did he? I mean, it was alright to start off with, but the match definitely ended up being very one-sided very quickly. So, unlucky son. Maybe next time. But at least he's returned and he's back, because he's something special, let me tell you. But now we await the arrival of Goldberg. When is he going to show up? How is he going to do it? Is he going to run in from the crowd? Is the music going to hit and he's going to walk out after slamming his head off the doors? He looks good with that championship. I reckon he's going to hold on to that for a long time as well. He's already held on to it since, I think, maybe Elimination Chamber or sometime before WrestleMania, because remember he faced Drew at WrestleMania. Drew lost, and then he lost again at Hell in a Cell. But wait, from out of nowhere, there was no warning, no indication, nothing. The music hits, and the man himself is back once again. The crowd chanting his name. It looks like they're happy to see him. I mean, no one's seen him yet. Where is he? Has he tripped on his way out? Goldberg! Goldberg! Oh, Burst of Pop. Oh, the Pyro, the classic. You know what, it is always great to see Goldberg. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not one of the Goldberg haters, you know? I'm not a hater, bro. I'm just a skater. Oh, oh, oh! Damn. Lashley looking a little bit concerned, you know? But we gotta remember, this man's like, what, 90? 100? 120? Nah, he's probably like, what, 50-something? Might be in his 60s, I don't know. Oh, that was a nice wee thing to do there. But, you know, if them two do have a match here at SummerSlam, it would be Bobby Lashley. There's no way he's losing to Goldberg. I know when Goldberg returns, 99% of the time, or maybe 100% of the time, he does win whichever feud he goes into. But Bobby Lashley ain't a regular person. I cannot accept the fact that this man on the right gets beat by this man on the left. Not a chance. I know this is scripted and all. Still having this whole thing. Let's go, champ. Shannon Briggs. But yeah, Goldberg still bringing the iconic phrase, you're next. Looks like that's gonna be it. But yeah, it is a simple message. We all know what's going to be happening here. Goldberg wants this championship. He wants a piece of the Almighty. This will be very interesting, you know. I'm sure a lot of you don't want to see Goldberg back and in a championship picture, but Bobby Lashley versus Goldberg is actually something that does tickle my fancy, you know. It's going to be interesting because I think we all expect Goldberg to win. But with Bobby Lashley, I think it could be very different. But then you just don't know. I think this match is pretty unpredictable. Yeah. And that's what I love about wrestling matches, where you don't really know what's going to happen. Some matches, you can easily predict the winner. But this one, would you agree with me here? I'm pretty sure this is quite unpredictable. Because I would never be surprised if Goldberg wins a championship on his return. But Bobby Lashley is doing so well. He's been having these squash matches against Kofi Kingston, you know, beating everyone in his path. Pretty much squashed Keith Lee there. So it's a very interesting one. I like it a lot. I'm very excited to see the match at probably SummerSlam 2021. This pay-per-view as well is going to be so good because we're already having, well, I'm pretty sure we're going to have the likes of Edge versus Seth Rollins. And then, of course, Roman Reigns versus John Cena. That's probably going to happen. I'm going to react to John Cena's promo here from Raw. So, multiple wrestling videos coming out today. Nikki Ash cashing in as well. That'll be a reaction. But yes, SummerSlam is going to be so good, I think. I've got high hopes for a living. For this SummerSlam. But anyways, that is it for now. So drop a like on the video for me if you've enjoyed. Subscribe if you're new. Thank you all for watching. And I'll see you in the next one.